Okay, the next tip I'm going to talk about is what's known as parallel compression, also referred to as New York drum compression. What the concept or theory behind this is that if we take our kick drum, snare drum, toms, leaving the hats, ride, and overheads untouched, but sending the kick and toms and snare to a compressor and heavily compressing them and pitting them up underneath the stereo mix of your regular drums, which gives you a little more oomph or beef or big bottom on the drums to make them cut through the mix a little more. So we'll show you how to do that. Basically, the first thing that we need to do is create a stereo auxiliary. And off the stereo auxiliary, I've put on a compressor and just use the standard compressor limiter dynamic 3 out of Pro Tools. A next step to the set the input to an available bus that we're not using. Currently, bus 1 and 2 is being used for a parallel reverb send, so I'll create a send or the input to bus 3 and 4. Now, on my kick drum, I'm going to create a send. Create this send to bus 3 and 4. I'm going to hold option. Click on my fader, brings me up to unity gain. I'm going to press follow main pan. So anything I do to the main pan, the send pan will follow. I'm going to hold option to create a copy to the kick out, snare top, snare bottom, tom 1, and tom 2. Now, in this particular song, he doesn't ever hit tom 1, but he does tom 2. So I really don't need to send for tom 1 because it's not being used. But I am not doing the overheads, ride, or hats. I don't want to overcompress signals. This is more about getting what's carrying that beat, that kick and snare, to be nice and punchy, big within the mix. So now, as I hit play, the send will come out of 3 and 4, come into 3 and 4 input on the auxiliary, and where I have my compressor, I'm going to just do a heavy compression. So I'm going to keep the ratio at around 3 to 1, 4 to 1 or so. Once we hit 4 to 1, we're actually going into a limiting mode. So we'll go, yeah, 3.4 to 1. As I bring in my input or my threshold, we can see how much reduction I'm getting here. So no reduction, bringing the threshold down, I start getting much more. So let's say that we're going to compress this by 12 to 15 dB, somewhere in there. Right, the attack is how fast the compressor kicks in. Get a little bit of a faster attack time, and I'm going to bring the release so it's a little slower. Let's back up on the threshold a little bit. Okay, so this becomes our compression return. Nice heavy compressed signal. And if I bring it down, I can set it within the mix. As we can see here, my output's nowhere near my input. So I'm going to match unity gain. I'm going to use the gain just to match what's coming into it. Without the compressed signal, with the compressed signal. We'll back it off in the mix a little bit. Okay, and after you've kind of played around with the different compressors, different attack times, release times to kind of set that in, if you hit it really, really hard, you can almost get a pumping effect to it. So I'd be careful with that, unless that's the sound you're going for. But it's supposed to be put really lightly into the mix just to kind of beef up the bottom end and give you a little more attack on the drums. So another little tip to make your mixes sound bigger and a little bit wider.